We are the press, the great free press, guardians of the national interest. We express all that is best in the ordinary, decent, law-abiding British public, yes. Dipping into dustbins, scrabbling for a smear, sniffing out a scandal, could the fellow be a queer? Do not be disheartened by what you cannot find, embroider or invent if you're inclined. For what appears in print is self-evidently true. Saw it in the papers, didn't you? A royal wedding we adore, the pomp and panoply of yore. We just as soon headline, of course, a royal scandalous divorce. And fearlessly our daily tune is down with trendy lefty loonies, down with militant lawbreakers, down with Marxist mischief makers, down with scroungers on the dole, and down with strikes except in Poland. Prying into privacy is a privilege of the press. Behind those white lace curtains hides a widow in distress. With patience, tact and sympathy, our duty we pursue, to obtain an exclusive interview. Cameras at the ready, now try and bravely smile, and here's a check we're sure will make it worth your while. Our hearts leap up when we behold a photogenic copper laid out cold. A callous car bomb never fails to give a healthy boost to sales. And fearlessly our daily tune is down with trendy lefty loonies, down with militant lawbreakers, down with Marxist mischief makers, down with scroungers on the dole, and down with strikes except in Poland, down with nuclear disarmers, down with fractious froggy farmers. Rape is what we relish, puts us in the mood to sermonise profoundly for your moral good. Where are the days when punishments were suitably severe and no decent woman walked the streets in fear? Our crusade for law and order will help to wipe out crime, but not, God save our sails, in our time. Tales of a ripper's lurid schemes disturb our readers' dearest dreams, while shapely ladies nicely nude brighten up the breakfast food. And fearlessly our daily tune is down with trendy lefty loonies, down with militant lawbreakers, down with Marxist mischief makers, down with scroungers on the dole, and down with strikes except in Poland, down with nuclear disarmers, down with fractious froggy farmers, down with so-called homeless squatters, down with Reds and commie plotters. Truth is what we strive for, we don't let bias show. Which side our bread is buttered is all we need to know. So without fear or favour we expose and we accuse, and what we don't choose to headline isn't news. A family on the breadline, a jobless suicide, may be worth the mention tucked away inside. To keep our readers up to date, we process, chew, digest, regurgitate assorted titbits culled from near and far, whose message is, let's keep things as they are. So, fearlessly, our daily tune is down with trendy lefty loonies, down with militant lawbreakers, down with Marxist mischief makers, down with scroungers on the dole, and down with strikes except in Poland, down with nuclear disarmers, down with fractious foggy farmers, down with so-called homeless squatters, down with Reds and commie plotters, down with all those rival bleeders trying to lure away our readers. We who stand for moderation pledge ourselves to save the nation
from those wild and wicked men, Scargill, Livingston and Ben, and all those hard left agitators and women never demonstrators and union bully boys and louts, Irish Argies, wogs and krauts, flying pickets, howling mobs, immigrants trying to steal our jobs. What we say is hang the muggers, deport the blacks, castrate the buggers, press the button, drop the bomb on peace campers at Greenham Common. We are the press, the great free press, guardians of the national interest. We express all that is best in the ordinary, decent, law-abiding British public, yes. Yes.